Hello and welcome to the ARCS, live here from Dover Motor Speedway for the running of the Denny 60. After an action-packed race at Phoenix, where we saw Ricky Quinn steal a victory late, making dangerous three-wide passes at every corner, now we arrive here at Dover for a new track in the ARCS, and maybe a new winner as well. Now let's take a look at your top 10 qualifiers in today's field. Starting on the pole is Ryan King. In second, Mike Kopas. In third, Ricky Quinn. In fourth, Roland Heidfeld. In fifth, Andy Seville. In sixth, Trevor Walker. In seventh, Glover Plummer. In eighth, Diego Tacone. In ninth, Theophilus Morgendorfer Sr. And rounding out your top 10, Christian Louisa. Let's take a look at the rest of the drivers in the field and get right on into the action at Dover. And we're live here at Dover. Richard Petty in the pace car is going to dive off. And Ryan King in that Furniture Row car is going to lead us to green here at Dover for the first time ever in the ARCS. In Season 1, we didn't have a Dover race, but in Season 2, we will. And looks like Mike Kopas on the outside with a good jump. Usually in the ARCS, the inside line has a pretty good jump on the restarts, but Ryan King definitely had a better Turn 1 than Mike Kopas, and Ryan King's going to probably get passed here by the 43, but the 43 is trying to block the 83 of Andy Seville. Andy Seville is trying to send it to the inside of Ryan King, but Andy Seville is getting hounded from behind by Blubber Plummer, I believe. Yep, not 27. Oh, and a little bit of contact for Diego Tacone. That's actually an understatement, because that was a massive hit for Diego Tacone. And that Miller machine, but a little bit of three wide back there, Manglos Stinglebench, and that's holding some guys around 10th place back, but definitely good battle for the lead here as we got Ricky Quinn, last week's winner, starting where he left off in first place. Ryan King hungry on that outside. Gonna try to roll the corner better than that 27 car for RCR, but that three car of Theophilus Morgendorfer Sr. is hungry for points here. And he, oh, and Andy Seville in the wall hard there. Let's see if there's a little damage. We might not get a good enough camera angle as they come around turn 3 and 4. Yeah, he does have damage, folks. He does have damage. That right quarter panel on the front of that thing is crinkled. But so far, so bueno here. Lap 5 of 60 complete here in the Denny 60. But Ricky Quinn starting off strong after, I said earlier, a win at Phoenix. So definitely keeping the hot streak going. But Ryan King definitely not a good start for Ryan King, as he was our pole sitter here at Dover, and he is already back to around 6th place, as he gets passed for 6th place, I should say. And Cassidy Reynolds going to go on by on the bottom as well, so Ryan King is on the conveyor belt backwards here. But Cassidy Reynolds making some spots up early here. But Andy Seville, another driver that started up for, oh, in that Darlington, well, not Darlington stripe, but the Dover stripe, I should say, because they do come off turn 3 and 4, or turn 1 and 2, I should say, turn 1 and 2 very fast here at Dover, so I'll call it the Dover stripe here. But Ryan King is the only car that's lost position and is still on that outside lane and has not been able to drop down. Ooh, and Ryan King does have a... Oh, and he's got a Dover stripe again. Ryan King just cannot get out of that outside wall. Coming out of 1 and 2, and that car on the right-hand side is absolutely junked. But Keith Vega up here in that 38 A&W car, looking to make a pass on Manglos Stinglebench, but Manglos Stinglebench got that good draft from the cars in front. But Ricky Quinn still leading this race, and let's take a look at the fastest lap as they come to lap 10. Fastest lap of the day is Keith Vega in the A&W car. So with the Denny's fastest lap, that goes to Keith Vega. So Keith Vega's looking to plug off some spots early in this race and hopefully mount a charge to Ricky Quinn. But you never know here. I mean, there's a lot of cars to get through before you get to Ricky Quinn. But Patrick Turner, I believe, in that 88 car, having a really good run after the last couple races have been kind of a down time in the season for him, but he is hoping to point his way into the ARCS playoffs, but obviously not been a good past couple races. Yeah, let's take a look through the field here. this. Got Keith Vega, obviously fastest lap leader. Good job for him. Got that Ryan King car with that right side damage, as we've been talking about pretty much all race, it seems. But Draymond Sandy in that 02 car, doing a good job riding the bottom and picking spots off here early. Trying to get inside the top 10. We got Mike Kopis underneath Trevor Walker, that 21 car. Matthew Bussey Jr., after last week at Phoenix, I mean, he absolutely clobbered that inside wall at Phoenix after Mike Kopis weakened the safer barrier. We got Jerry Funk back here, last season's champion. Whoa, and Noah Hobson and Denzel Scott put on the binders coming off a 1 and 2. Almost like there was something in front of the track that made him slow down, but they might actually make contact here. Oh, three wide. We got, oh, almost three wide. Let's take a look at this. This will be interesting, folks. Three wide at Dover does not work. Let's see if it works coming out of 1 and 2. Oh, and it doesn't work. Denzel Scott in the wall hard, along with Maxwell Smart back there. I just had to see what was going to happen there. You usually don't see a lot of three wide at Dover that works out too well, and that was just another example of things not working out here at Dover when it comes to three wide. Jack Porter back here, a winner earlier this season, got his first career victory. Ellie Buss with damage. Dave Wilson back here. Quinn Porter with some right side. Oh, and Diego Tacon in the wall again. Diego Tacon must have a loose setup in that car because he has been in the wall all race long. And it's going to be a long one for Diego Tacon if he cannot get that car figured out, as he is in the last place position, I believe. So he's fighting that 41 car, both cars with right side damage. So these cars back here definitely got a lot of damage. You can tell they are not set up correctly for this track. But, I mean, first time at Dover for the ARCS, so what can you expect? You don't have any expectations because it's just, you know, come here, drive, you know, what you got. And obviously, you know, you can come down pit road, but it's going to cost you. So obviously, definitely not a great race for those drivers in the back. But Jordan, I believe that's the 10 car Jordan Walker. Yep, that's Jordan Walker, the brother to Trevor Walker. But ooh, Jordan Walker almost gave the 77 a shot going into turn 3 and 4, or turn 1 and 2, I should say. Both sets of corners here at Dover do look pretty similar, so I apologize if I get the corners messed up. But Matthew Bussey Jr. looking to the inside at Indy Seville. I believe this is for probably around 13th or 14th, if I guess correctly here, as we're looking through the ticker. Yep, 13th and 14th, perfect guess. So, and Bussey's gonna get 13th from Andy Seville. But Keith Vega still back here with that fastest lap award last time we checked. We'll take a look. Yep, Keith Vega still fastest with the fastest lap of the race. But in the Denny 60, we've got 20 of 60 complete here, a fourth of the way through this event, so, or a third. Well, I don't know. I'm bad at math, so we'll just say it's either a third or a fourth. It's a third. So, yeah. So, Ricky Quinn, just don't ask me to do math here in the booth, but the 43 of Ricky Quinn, still leading here at Dover. That's the Smithfield colors out front as they were last weekend, so I believe, if I remember correctly, this would be the first time in ARCS history that we'd have a back-to-back winner, so I don't know. We might be setting records this season, and this might be one of them, so we'll definitely have to wait and see. But Denzel Scott, not a good day for Denzel Scott after getting hung out to dry three wide in the corner and paying the ultimate price here at Dover with that Dover stripe. But Clay Stone, I believe, started up about mid-pack, and he has definitely dropped like a rock. A lot of cars here, as you can tell, if they are not set up for this track, they have a right-side stripe on them. Noah Hobson's got a little bit of a crinkle in that car, but we'll go through the field here and take a look at some drivers. Tony Jansen up here. How about Tony Jansen? Had a down about 2 or 3 weeks ago. He had just been involved in every single crash, you know, you could imagine, but last couple weeks, he's been pulling it together in the ARCS, so good job for Rick, or not Ricky Quinn, Tony Jansen. Sorry, Tony Jansen. But Trevor Walker up here doing a good job. I mean, he's been another driver that's had a couple down weeks, but definitely trying to rebound here. Even if it's not a great top 10 finish, you still don't get involved in a crash. And speaking of crashes, as we said on Ryan Hubbs in that 14 car, he has been upside down, through the air, on top of people. He's been everywhere. He's been everywhere but probably the top 5 and victory lane this season. So if he could get things turned around, that would definitely be a miracle story here in the ARCS. But speaking of miracle stories, Jerry Funk, if I remember correctly, early in season one of the ARCS, went for a flip at Atlanta and later went on to win the championship. So you never know here in the ARCS. But speaking of never know, we'll take a look at the top drivers. But things definitely got strung out here in this race as Blubber Plummer in that 27 has lost some time to the 43, but we're still got a long way to go here in this race, so not even halfway complete. We're lap 27, coming to 28 here as Theophilus almost tried to get a pass completed on the 27, but as that three car showed at Phoenix, there is no mercy that will be shown for any driver that gets in front of that three car, as the three car set a lot of people three wide at Phoenix, so we'll see if that three car can complete the pass. And the three car, we'll see, completes the pass. Good job for the three car. And the three car takes the second position, but we'll see here. That 27 can pull the crossover move. Ooh, and that 27 will. See going in three and four here, if that 27 can slide up in front of the three car. Ooh, and the 27 might. Oh, and almost a little contact between the 3 and the 27. We'll see who rolls this corner better, but that is a perfect sight that Ricky Quinn wants to see, and his rearview mirror is 2x2. But, ooh, and the 3 car almost, I believe, got in the wall, but that's going to allow the 88 to get underneath the 3, and the 3 is going for a backward slide here at Dover. That 3 can't pop down into that, bottom lane, and the 88 of Patrick Turner sends it up the track to block the 3 car. This definitely spells doom for that car's race. Ooh, as he gets in the wall off of turn one and two again. That three car is doomed here, but hopefully that does not cause a caution later in this race. But I just might have jinxed Theophilus Morgendorfer Sr., but Cassidy Reynolds to the inside. Cassidy Reynolds, I believe, had a fairly good fast lap throughout this track. I believe it was the second or third fastest lap on the charts. Whoa, and a little bit of contact between the 12 and 3. Almost a wreck on the backstretch. That is obviously not something that Ricky Quinn wants to see, but that 3 car has a lot of damage on that right-hand side as we pan the camera here, and you can see that car is absolutely messed up on the right-hand side. Probably going to get in the wall again. Oh, and it just doesn't let up here at Dover. The Dover stripe, the Dover smack has continued. That 96 on Manglo Stinglebench going to get around, and is the 3 car? Yep, the 3 car drops in line finally. But that damage will definitely hinder that 3 car. And we'll go back to the front of the pack. But Blubber Plummer's gained ground on that 43 car of Ricky Quinn. It's not over here. And it definitely isn't over, as we have about 26 laps left here in this race. But we'll definitely pay attention to the delta between the first and second place car here at Dover. See if the draft helps at all. But we got a pack of lap cars that just came to the start-finish line. And the leaders, we don't know position-wise where the leaders are. Okay, so they're coming to the white flag, They're coming to the start-finish line now. So they're about a set of corners in front of Ricky Quinn, but almost halfway complete here, halfway complete here in this race. But we'll see if Ricky Quinn can catch some lap cars. I mean, lap cars have been the theme of the past couple races here in the ARCS. They have definitely changed some finishes here. Let's take a look at the fastest lap, and the Denny's fastest lap is still going to Keith Vega in that 38 machine. But second, Cassidy Reynolds still in third, John Hendricks, fourth, Andy Spill, fifth, Jordan Walker, good to see him up there, sixth, I believe that's Patrick Turner, yep, and Patrick Turner is third place, so obviously good for him. So yeah, that's just a quick rundown on the fastest lap. They haven't been setting fastest laps recently, so the laps that stood at the beginning of the race are still standing here. No, I'm not talking about Elton John. They are still standing. But Ricky Quinn just being dominant here at Dover, but I believe that 43 is slowing down. The race pace, the long-term race pace for that 43 has slowed down just a little bit. But he picked it up in one and two here. He was just trying to tease me, but that 27 had caught up a lot to that 43 car, Ricky Quinn. As we come to the stripe, 20 laps to go here in the Denny's 60, so the Denny's 20 to go. And speaking of the Denny's 20 to go, we can take a look at the top 20 cars here in the race. Plummer in second and third. We got Patrick Turner in fourth. John Hendricks in fifth. Cassidy Reynolds. Sixth, Sean Carson in seventh. Manglo Singlebench in eighth. Keith Vega. Ninth, Draven Sandy. 10th, with that battered car, Theophilus Morganover Sr. 11th, Matthew Bussey Jr. 12th, Jordan Walker. 13th, Ringus McDingus. 14th, Jerry Funk. 15th, Andy Seville. 16th, Darren Kiefer. 17th, Michael Redinger. 18th, Ryan Hubbs. 19th, Ryan King. And rounding out your top 20 for the Denny's 20 to go, we got John Ross Stein in 20th. So there's your top 20 rundown at Dover. As you can see, the top 20 drivers in this field, as we just showed you. Just to give you a little bit more interaction with the drivers in the mid-pack, we try not to focus on the lead too much, but when we do, we just make sure to give everybody else a little bit of airtime here at Dover. But Ricky Quinn just still holding on strong, but Ricky Quinn wasn't as strong at Phoenix as some people would probably think. That 43 car came on strong late in that race. Was not as dominant as Dover here today. That 27 car, hoping that 43 can make a mistake soon, because it is coming down to closing time here at Dover, and you want to be in the lead when the white flag waves here today, because that would secure the first ever completed race in the ARCS at Dover. So you want to be the first ever winner at a new track. And speaking of new tracks, we've got a bunch of new tracks coming up here in the ARCS. We got, I believe next week or 2 weeks from now, we have Watkins Glen, so first road course race of the season, so that'll be interesting. And then we also have Twin Ring Motegi going to Japan with these ARCS cars, so you'll definitely have to stay tuned for the next couple weeks because it will be interesting. As Ricky Quinn still leading this race, very impressive drive for that 43 car. Patrick Turner has been gaining time on that 27 just slightly as it looks going into turn 1 and 2, but I don't know, they just really are spaced out perfectly here at Dover. As we saw throughout this race, I mean, Ricky Quinn's just put on a clinic here at Dover. But that 88 might look to the inside of the... Oh, that 88 gets a little loose on the bottom and just drops back just slightly. That 88 is definitely gunning for second place. Patrick Turner's probably thinking second is better than third here, because Ricky Quinn is probably going to steal this one away, folks. But Patrick Turner's not going to give up without a fight here. We could see a late race caution or lap cars playing in this race, and I believe that 27 got in the wall just slightly. The pressure has been building against that 27, and Patrick Turner is ready to pounce here. Ooh, and so is that 7 of John Hendricks as he drops below Patrick Turner as well. So we got a 3-car battle for second place, but it's settled out here. Ooh, as Patrick Turner gets a little tight and almost whacks the wall, but definitely better than the lead here, because Ricky Quinn has just been dominant all day, and we've got 10 laps to go, coming to 9 laps to go here in this race. One thing Ricky Quinn would not like to see is a late race caution. But we'll see if the 7 and 88 can prove them wrong here. Ooh, as they go too wide, this is possibly going to give that 7 car the position, and I believe it will. Ooh, but will that 88 drop below the 7? Will we get a crossover move here in 1 and 2? No, that 7 is definitely faster than the 88. That 7's up to third place. Ooh, but a bad exit to 2 there for the 7 car. That 88 is right back to him. The 43 of Ricky Quinn. My goodness, 2 weekends in a row could be making history here today at Dover. Not just with the first ever Dover race in the ARCS, but with a 2 in a row here for Ricky Quinn. That could be an impressive feat, but we still have 7 laps to go, almost 6 laps to go here. But Patrick Turner could get into the 7 car and cause a caution, or another car could cause a caution. You never know here at this track. And just have to remember that this is a self-cleaning racetrack. If you spin or get turned, and just as I say that, a car goes around the 88 in the wall. Will it take out any other drivers? And I spoke that caution almost into existence. I believe, yep, no caution light is out. So Ricky Quinn and their pit crew on the pit box is breathing a sigh of relief. But that 88 might just become a moving target for other drivers to potentially get into, as we got two wide, Bangalo Stinglebench and Keith Vega back there. That could be another caution waiting to happen. Five laps to go, folks. Overtime could be needed here. And that's definitely not something we would have said earlier in this race, as it has went green since the wave of that green flag. But Blubber Plummer still trying to... Ooh, as we got the 12 dropping below the 88 and the 96 dropping below the 36. So we'll see here what happens. Ooh, is that 12 car Sean Carson looking to get around that heavily damaged 88? I don't know how that 88 is still on pace here. I thought that 88 was going around. Whoa, 88 slow in the corner, and the 36 is going to dive bomb below the 88. Mangalo Stinglebench to follow here. Ooh, but will he make the pass off the corner? This could get interesting, folks. We've got two to three laps to go here in this race. Ricky Quinn does not want to see a caution, but we should focus in on those three cars because that could be a caution here. Ooh, is the 88 in the wall, but they are clean, and everyone's single file. And all Ricky Quinn has to do is complete the next two laps, and it is over, folks. But Blubber Plummer trying to cut the gap between him and Ricky Quinn. It would be a miracle here at Dover. That 27 could somehow get past the 43, but I don't think it's going to happen here, folks. Just a dominant performance for that 43, as the flagman's going to wave the white flag. There it is. One lap to go in the Denny 60. And almost all 60 laps here have been dominated, absolutely dominated by that 43 machine. And the hot streak is continuing here in the ARCS for that 43 car, as Ricky Quinn's going to come off turn 3 and 4 and be the winner here at the Denny 60 for the first time ever at Dover. Congratulations to that 43 of Ricky Quinn for the second week in a row in the ARCS, so a new record in the ARCS. So congratulations once more to Ricky Quinn here at Dover. And we're back here at Dover Motor Speedway after the running of the Denny 60. And Ricky Quinn with a dominating win. And the second win for Ricky Quinn on the season, and a second in a row. So a hot streak is brewing here for that Richard Petty Motorsports team, as obviously Ricky Quinn collected the victory here today. Blubber Plummer just could not get around that 43 car and get second place. In third, John Hendricks after a solid day. In fourth, Cassidy Reynolds. In fifth, Sean Carson. In sixth, Keith Vega. In seventh, Mangalo Stinglebench. In eighth, Patrick Turner after whacking the wall about midway through the race and almost causing a caution late with about five laps to go. In ninth, Jordan Walker. And rounding out your top 10, last season's champ, Jerry Funk. Let's take a look at the rest of the drivers. And all of the drivers here in today's race finished, and no cautions. I believe this is the first time in ARCS history, at least this season, that we've not had a caution during a race. So everybody kept it clean, except for Patrick Turner, who almost brought out a caution. But good job for everybody here today. So congratulations for no cautions here today and keeping out of the wall. And also to Ricky Quinn here at Dover.